on over to the tram.
Let's go!
No, they're not dancers and they're not exercise fanatics. These young people are warming up for another kind of activity, a sport that's rapidly becoming popular in Canada. I'm at the Richmond Hill Trampoline Club in Ontario. It's special because it was Canada's first registered trampoline club.
Leslie, will you go up and do your routine, please?
It's trampolining, a form of gymnastics developed in the late 1930s. It was founded in 1971 by its present coach, Frank Juhasz, who in the 1950s was ranked as one of the top 10 trampolinists in the United States. Juhasz has served as trampoline chairman of Canada and may be a judge in this year's Canadian Trampoline Championships to be held in Vancouver.
Here you go, Les. Okay, go ahead, Richard. And Kathy, would you go up? Spot him on a few.
In past Canadian competitions, Ontario has traditionally had most of Canada's best male bouncers, while British Columbia has had the best women. Canada hopes to send its champs, some of which rank amongst the top 10 in the world, to the 1984 Olympics, where trampolining will be demonstrated for the first time in Olympics history. Juhasz coaching may be responsible for some of our future trampoline champions. He starts training them as young as 7, and a few beginners, such as 7-year-old Christy Cooperwaite, show promise. Well, it may look easy, but trampolining is actually a very difficult sport. It requires a good sense of balance and a lot of acrobatic skills. I think I'm just gonna try some of my fancy stuff here. I'm Orly Cone, and I think I need a little more practice. Somebody get me down from here.